John wrote with a very deep love for the human race and a concern for its future. Yoko Ono.
And John would say, whenever you didn't understand anything of Yoko's, he says, I'm on guard. That was his favorite expression, is I'm on guard, Phil. You don't understand it because it's I'm on guard. So I just said it's I'm on guard because I didn't understand any of it. No, I did. It was very good. But if you didn't understand it, he told everybody it was avant garde. And if you didn't understand her music, it was avant garde.
John Lennon met Yoko Ono for the first time at her art show, Unfinished Paintings and Objects, at the Indica Gallery in London on November 9, 1966. But he was married to Cynthia, and though he was attracted to Yoko, they reportedly did not become a couple until May of 1968. The inevitable divorce from Cynthia came on November 8, 1968, and as the end of the decade approached, John and Yoko married in Gibraltar on March 20, 1969.
I mean, they were true lovers. They were best friends, which I don't know how many people know. There was an image about them in the public, and then there was the real John and Yoko, and the real John and Yoko were really John and Yoko. I mean, they really loved each other, and they were best pals.
They realized that their honeymoon would receive a great deal of worldwide media attention and decided to utilize this to bring their message of love to the world. They staged two peaceful bed-in protests. The first took place in Amsterdam, and 2 months later it was repeated in Montreal. Between the two events, John and Yoko began other peace campaigns, most notably Bagism, which John explained as the most direct way to sell the message of peace. By removing the visual of himself and Yoko, he hoped that people would pay attention to their message. On June 1, 1969, whilst in Montreal's Queen Elizabeth Hotel, John wrote, performed, and recorded Give Peace a Chance, which became the anthem for the peace movement.
First of all, he wrote a song called Give Peace a Chance to give a rally cry for people, instead of fighting, and find a place to become positive by using Give Peace a Chance as an anthem.
It just seems to me that people who usually advocate peace, it's not what everyone else wants as far as the government is concerned. And it's too bad because it's not that difficult to put down a gun and to just love your enemy. You know, and I think that that's what John Lennon was all about, and it touches me very deeply.
He was not a pacifist. He was a peace activist, but peace activist does not mean being a lame-o or being a liberal, or being a limousine liberal. It doesn't mean just going like this and doing nothing. Sometimes it means going like this to the power structure and doing more than that. Sometimes it means revolution. And he, in his songs, he said, I don't want to be part of revolution that's violent, but he didn't want to be part of the revolution.